Welcome to this video. This is going to be a quick one where I'm showing how to interact with processes on a Linux machine. I'm going to use Ubuntu underneath WSL. I just want to kind of show how you're able to query processes, how to kill processes. Very easy. I'm going to actually add a few windows here. I'm going to add about, there we go, quad view. And here in the upper left-hand corner, I'm just going to type in the command top. This is going to allow me to see processes that are currently running on my machine. I get a process ID. I get the user that's running the process and additional information like how much CPU and memory, how long it's been up, and what command is being ran. You get a lot of good information here. What I'm going to do is because currently I'm logged in as the Ubuntu user, I want to see processes just underneath that user. What I'll do is do a control C to exit out of this. Because when you look at processes, it is in real time. What I will do, I'll do a top dash U, the actual username. So just do Ubuntu. So now this will real time filter the list of processes. So I'll see only the processes that are ran by this user. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use these two bottom panes to run some processes. So let's do a ping localhost. And what we'll end up seeing is that now a new record has been added called ping, because that's the command that I'm running. So we can see it's running under the user, and there is the process ID in that case. So now what I'll do is I'll do a control C to kill my process, and it should then be removed from the list of running processes. So let's do a ping over here, and we'll also do a ping over here as well. So now we're going to have two processes, and notice we have two pings right there. So I can kill those processes both with a control C, and they'll be removed from this list. I'll do this again. I'll run ping again on both of these. We'll see these are both being added to the list. And now we're going to kill the process by ID. So what I'll do is a kill command, and I'll do 1706, because that's the second ping ID, process ID, hit enter. And now notice that has stopped it in the terminal and it has been removed from the list. I can do the same thing with the 1691 and now that command has also been killed. We'll do the ping again. And this time what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to kill processes by name. So in this case, we have two processes that are using the ping command. Instead of killing them by ID, I want to kill both of these processes at the same time or relatively at the same time using a singular command. So what I can do is a pkill and then actually let's do a pgrep. And then what is the command that we're looking for? We're looking for ping. We see we have two processes which match those numbers here. So I can then turn around and do a pkill ping. And now it has killed both of those processes. All right, another use case is, let's say we have a while statement. So I will say while true, do, and I'll say echo hello world and done. Well, notice this doesn't come up in the process ID in that case, because this is running and getting killed immediately. So I'll do a control C because it's a while loop. So every time it runs the echo command, but it then dies. If I add another command here, let's say sleep for 1 second. Now watch what happens. In our process, we do have a sleep command, but look at the process ID. It keeps changing. It executes and then it terminates. So this shows you that this is not the same process. So even if I did a kill on 2564, the loop itself is still running. And so we get a new process ID, which is sleep. So in order to kill this type of thing, we want to put it into a file. So we're going to go ahead and copy that. And we're going to do vim demo test.sh. And we're going to insert that statement. And we're just going to do a bin bash at the top. Hit enter. And we'll do a chmod plus x on that file. And then now we're going to call that file. So now we have a file calling this while loop. And now in the process, we have the file. And then we do have this sleep command. Notice the sleep command does continue to get an updated ID every second. What we can do in this case, since it's coming from a file, we can kill the file. So if I do a, let's do a pgrep. And it does find that ID. And let me just double check. So it is, it's like a regex pattern. So it's just looking anywhere where a process has a name demo. So demo test 2844, that does match. So I can either do a kill on that, and now that's been killed. And then it also terminates the sleep command because it was executing from the file. I can also do the pgrep as well. So pgrep demo test 3258, and then just do the pkill command 3258. Oh, my apologies. I can do the pkill on demo test. There we go. So now that has been terminated. So that's just a quick way of how you can query processes. Let me also do that. I'll do the ping a local host, and we'll do that demo test. And what you can do is a PSAUX. And in this case, what we can do is the PS command. This what this will show you. So what we can do is a PS-U, then Ubuntu. This will show us, just like over here, the list of processes in this case that are running, and the numbers will match up. And we're going to have this extra command because PS itself is a process. We can do a PS-U Ubuntu. This is going to give us the list of commands or processes. And what we can do is we can do that pkill demo test, pkill ping. Now, if we're running as another user, for example, if I'm running as ute, if I'm running as root, I don't know why I said ute, I'll do a sudo su. So now I'm the root user, and I'll do a ping localhost, and I'll do a ping localhost while I'm logged in as the regular user, my Ubuntu user. And notice on the processes, if I kill the root one, that's not going to show up because, again, we're filtering out what's the command for the Ubuntu user. So I'm going to run ping again over here. What I can do is that /u, this case root, and notice we do have ping here at the bottom. So that's actually the ping command. Now, if I try to do a kill on 4744, I don't have permission to do that. That's the another user's process. Because I do have access to do sudo, I can do a sudo kill 4744, and now that has been terminated. So it's important to know the process that you're trying to kill, if you need additional permissions to kill that process. But this is just a quick video. Hopefully this is helpful and get you an idea of how to interact with processes on Linux. So thanks. Catch you in the next one. Bye.